Hello everyone and welcome back to our series on Unity DOTS. If you don't have the project in the state I'm showing you now, head down to the description to download the startup project or check out the series from the beginning. Let's continue that journey today and tame those wild cubes to bend their path to our will. Okay, for now our cubes are hard-coded to move forward, and I would like to control two things. One, how fast they are moving, and two, where they are going. And for that, we'll need to declare our own components. Let's start with their movement speed. To keep things tidy, we will create a new folder in our script folder to store our component. Create a new folder called components. In that components folder, right-click and go to create. ECS, runtime component type. And give it a name that is representative of the data it will contain. And open it in your script editor. Just like the system we created in the last video, the template we just used already gives us some useful information. As we can see in the comment, the component itself only contains data and don't define any behavior. That's why we have system. Also, the component can only contain what is called bleatable data. That means only primitive types and other structs that contains only primitive types. I would like to add that strings and arrays are not supported. If you want the full details of what data is supported in a component, I've added a link to the documentation just below the like button. The last part of the comment tells us that we should make this data structure the most efficient for runtime use. Not easy to use in the editor. For that, we will have another kind of components called authoring components. And in the next video, we will see those in details. There is also a few things I would like to point out that are not mentioned in the comment. As you can see, the component is a struct, not a class, and it also implements the IComponentData interface. This is one of several interfaces that define the component types. In this video, we will see this one and another one, so stay tuned. Okay, now that we know what a runtime component is, we can define our speed component. We can just remove all the comments and define a public float called value. If you recall, in the last video, to create our entities, we used GameObject. So we will need a way to add this speed component to our GameObject. Since it's not a mono behavior, we can't do that directly. We will need to define the authoring component. For such a simple component, we can use the nd attribute generate authoring component that will take care of that for us. For our speed to have any impact on our cube, we will need to take that speed into account in our move system. So, open the move system and add the speed parameter in the lambda expression. Finally, multiply the movement by the speed value. Save the file and go back to the Unity editor. In the GameObject hierarchy, select the cube, and in the inspector, add the speed component. Set the value to 2. Do the same thing for the other cube. But this time, set the value to 1. Enter play mode. And now, we can see that one of our cubes is moving twice as fast as the other one. Okay, great! We have accomplished the first of our two objectives. If you like the video so far, please hit the like button. Now, what about bending their path to our will? For that, we will need a way to store a list of points that our cubes will follow. But Mark, you just told us that we can't store arrays in our components and list our class, so we can't use that either. You are correct, that's why we have another type of runtime component. Let's make it. Once again, in the components folder, create another runtime component. Call it waypoints and open it in your code editor. To be able to store a list of values, we won't use the IComponentData interface. Instead, we will use the IBufferElementData interface. This interface will tell the ECS framework that this component represents a single element of a list that needs to be associated with an entity. So for a single waypoint, we will need to define an XYZ coordinate, so a float 3. We can replace the comments with a public float 3 value. Once again, to be able to set our waypoints in the editor, we will need an authoring component, so we can add the generate authoring component tag. For the cube to follow the path, we also need to know what is the next waypoint it should move to. We can define another IComponentData this time to store the index of the path it should move to. For the authoring component to be generated, we must define the component in a new file, otherwise it will not work. You can either create the component from the Unity editor or use the refactoring tool at your disposal. Last thing to do in the code editor, we need to use those components in our system. Open the move system, and in the lambda expression after the translation, you can add the next path index component as a ref parameter, because we will need to update it once the cube has reached the waypoint. For the waypoints, we want to have access to all the waypoints, not only a single waypoint. To have access to all the waypoints, we need to add it as a dynamic buffer. This dynamic buffer will behave similarly to an array. Now, in the code execution, we can compute the direction in which the cube should move based on its position and the next waypoint. If the cube reaches its destination, we need to set the path index to the next waypoint. And here I will show you a neat little trick for the cube to loop back to the beginning of the path once it has reached the end of it. By using the modulo operator with the length of our path, once we've reached the last path index, it will loop back to zero. And finally, we use the normalized direction as our direction vector. We can save all our files and go back to the Unity editor. In both cube inspector, add the waypoints and next path index components. Set a couple of waypoints. And hit play mode. And as you can see, we have accomplished our second objective. We can now control the direction our cubes are moving and how fast they are moving. But the authoring experience is not great. We have to define several components, we have to define the path using float values. It would be much better if we could add just a single component and define the path in the scene directly. So that's what we will see in the next video. In the meantime, you can follow us on Twitter, where I posted about the release of Unity Netcode for GameObject. You can also check out our other video. Even if you already know about the video's topic, there may still be some stuff for you to discover. And as usual, like, comment, share, and subscribe to get notified of future videos. See you next time.